Hi, welcome back to our masterclass on data governance with AWS. I'm Kevin Lewis, and now I'd like to talk about the relationship of governance to artificial intelligence and machine learning. First, I'm going to use the terms artificial intelligence and machine learning somewhat interchangeably. Technically, there's differences. Machine learning is a way to implement artificial intelligence, but for our purposes, we can just use the terms interchangeably. So thinking about the relationship of governance to machine learning, let's think about it in a few different ways. First, let's think about data governance as we've been talking about it to this point and how it relates to supporting machine learning capability. And then let's talk about special considerations as it relates to machine learning that adds additional responsibilities to our program that may not be in place with a data governance program. And then let's talk a little bit about generative AI in particular and some of the things that we want to think about as it relates to generative AI and the special considerations there. So the first thing is to understand is that all of the things that we've been talking about as it relates to data governance apply to machine learning. So what I'm saying here is, as you think about how to apply machine learning to produce value in your organization, you're going to discover that the underlying data needs to be in a condition to meet the needs of the specific initiatives associated with the machine learning. Things like, you know, master data management, when we talk about linking customer data or product data from a variety of sources, when we think about regulatory compliance and data lineage and all of those same things, we don't want to have to rediscover the need for data governance as a result of building machine learning capability. So it's better to go into the program knowing that there should be a partnership between the data governance program and machine learning, just as the data governance program supports applications and analytics more generally. In fact, with a lot of investment in artificial intelligence, if the data governance is not yet in place the way you would like it to be, you know, we talked about using funding and supporting funded initiatives. If there is a lot of interest and funding behind artificial intelligence and machine learning, you can actually use that to drive your data governance program and begin the process of maturing it, and likewise use that to support the value proposition outside of the machine learning capability. So, you know, again, the main point here is to think about data governance as getting data in the condition to meet the needs of business initiatives. It applies to artificial intelligence and machine learning, just as it does to other analytics and applications. In fact, some surveys indicate that, 20% or fewer machine learning models ever make it to production. And, you know, so one of the things to think about is, what will it take to actually get a model confidently into production? And that is when things like data quality management and master data management and you know, generally the reliability of data and protecting the data becomes even more crucial, because it's one thing to experiment with a model, but it's quite another to get that implemented into production. So that's the first thing, is make sure we're aligning these programs. In fact, when we talked about a roadmap and what a roadmap looks like, think of artificial intelligence and machine learning as within the application track. You can literally fold these use cases into that roadmap along with other use cases to be supported by similar data. It doesn't have to be a complete machine learning roadmap. It can be machine learning embedded into a larger data strategy roadmap, and then that emphasizes the point that we want to make data governance a part of that overall process, just like with the other capabilities we talked about. Okay, so that's the relationship between data governance and machine learning in general. Now let's talk about the special considerations as it relates to machine learning. So one special consideration for machine learning is the new kinds of data structures that we want to bring into our governance program. So for example, let's think about feature stores. just like we talked about, not wanting to do the same data management work over and over again and integrating data from multiple sources and building confidence in that data and doing it over and over again for various initiatives, we find the same thing in model development when it comes to building the structures that are essential specifically for machine learning, like feature stores. So rather than building feature stores just for one individual use case, if I have a roadmap of where this is going, I can think about the kinds of features that are going to be needed across a wide variety of machine learning models. And then I can use my data governance program to think cross-functionally about building feature stores that can be used across those use cases. And just like we talked about with data governance, we don't have to build out all possible features all at once. But as we roll out more and more use cases, rather than starting from scratch, we can build those feature stores and extend them and enhance them and things like that. So we end up with an inventory of feature stores that are available for, again, a variety of machine learning models. And so the same things that we talked about where, you know, profiling the data for quality and monitoring for quality and things like that, when it comes to data lakes and data warehouses and so on, can also apply to feature stores as a part of the architecture. The other things that you need to think about are regulatory compliance. So within our data governance program, we already want to look at security and privacy and all of that. There's new legislation being proposed all the time as it relates to machine learning, and we're going to see more and more of that. So much like we are taking a look at regulatory compliance as it relates to data in general, there's different and special considerations as it relates to machine learning. And just looking at it from a company policy and an ethics perspective and things like keeping our customer data private and using data appropriately, this has to be a very conscious track within any machine learning program. So let's talk then about generative AI in particular. You know, this is obviously a profound change in technology. And so again, there are still a lot of the same elements underneath in terms of pulling data together and relying on the data that feeds generative AI, just like it would any other use case. But again, there are special considerations as it relates to generative AI. So things like unlabeled data. So you have labeled data and you have unlabeled data. We talked earlier, for example, about claims processing or claims adjudication. So imagine now that you have generative AI fishing through a lot of freeform text to support the process of adjudicating claims. Well, now the completeness and the accuracy of the information inside the claims that are going to be used to feed these models, both in terms of inference, which is sort of using the models in production, but also in terms of training and customizing, fine-tuning, this is going to take on added importance. Or you can think about like a CRM system. So if you are going to use generative AI to enhance your relationship with your customer, and you have information that's captured in a CRM system, and there's, again, a lot of free-form text, a lot of information that can be used to both in inference and in fine-tuning and things like that, the governance over that information and the collection of that information and having confidence in it is going to be all the more important. So we talked before about that we need a business and IT partnership. So if we are using that information, like in a CRM system, to feed models in one way or another, then it's going to be all the more important to have a partnership between IT and the business where there may be new training that's required. There may be new processes that need to take place because the operational processes that produce this information need to be substantial enough to feed these models so that they can make accurate recommendations and they can become a part of the overall business process. Also, you're going to have, again, additional regulatory issues because things like visibility into what these models are doing. There needs to be adequate documentation about what is being done inside the models and how they are producing their results. So you're going to see, again, more and more regulations specifically around the use of generative AI in business processes. Okay, so the special considerations as it relates to machine learning, things we need to think about in addition to the relationship between machine learning and data governance, is the governance of the machine learning process itself. So, you know, building, testing, deploying models into production, those kinds of things need monitoring. There needs to be a process to make that as efficient as possible so that it's as repeatable as possible. So we can efficiently go through the whole process and end up with these models in production. We call that ML ops. So institutionalizing the process of going through all of those phases and making it as effective as possible, supported by technology, is something we want to think about. Also, documentation. So when we are building machine learning models, and again, not just for regulatory compliance, but in general, so that we have a handle on the machine learning process, every machine learning model, especially if it's going to be deployed in production, is going to have some documentation associated with it. Things like, what are the special ethical considerations as it relates to this model? Things like bias and things that we need to be concerned about. How was the model trained? What data was used? What kind of freshness do we expect in terms of the data to feed this model? So we want to be able to automate that as much as we possibly can, but it's also going to require some level of governance to make sure that we're documenting these models adequately so we have confidence in what we're doing and we have a record of what the model does and how it's managed and all of that. With generative AI, there's some additional things to think about. So which model to use under what circumstances? It's not just one foundation model to consider to meet the needs of use cases. There's a wide variety of foundation models for various uses, and they're each good at different things. So applying governance to the selection process of which model to use under what circumstances is something that's going to be very helpful. Or even chaining multiple models together in an application. So the inventory and capability of the various models that you use in your organization, how they are customized, how they're chained together in applications, these are things you don't want to have to figure out with every single project. These are things that you have to establish as standards and, of course, continuously improve. And we want to make that a part of the overall governance process. Also, monitoring for things like bias and toxicity and some of the things that are somewhat unpredictable about what these generative AI models can produce. There's things we can do to proactively monitor the output of what these models do so that we are being careful to monitor for things like bias and toxicity. However, you also have to be careful, just like everything else we've talked about, this is a balancing act. So you don't want to restrict the model so significantly that you're missing an opportunity to learn something. So let's take, for example, product reviews. Okay, so maybe you're looking for product reviews on and social media comments on your products, and you're bringing that together and bringing that into a generative AI model to make a determination about what the feedback is on particular products. Well, maybe you're going to learn something about products that might be a little unpleasant to learn about. And if you do that, you want to be careful not to change the model so much that you don't pick up on very important strategic feedback that you get from these models, and then you end up losing that insight. So monitoring for bias, monitoring for toxicity, but being very careful to be open to learning something about what it is that that you're trying to learn about. You have to be conscious of what's happening with your data. So these models that are being used for generative AI, these are typically pre-built models that you can then customize. But what is happening to the data that you're using, both in inference and in terms of fine-tuning? Where is that data going? Is the model provider using that data without your customer's knowledge to continuously improve their own models? You need to be conscious of what's happening with the data that you're providing to these models, and you want to be able to protect your customer's data and your own sensitive data from being used by model providers without your knowledge or consent. In summary, the main thing to do is to make sure that your data governance program is supporting your machine learning and artificial intelligence capability just as it is other analytics capabilities. And you need to add to the program things that are necessary for governance of machine learning itself and for traditional machine learning as well as generative AI. So we want to make that part of one overall program rather than discovering the need for the underlying data governance separately as part of your AIML program. You want to proactively consider how these things link together. We also talked previously about the analytics community and organizing the analytics community. We should make machine learning a part of that wider community because these capabilities are going to serve the similar constituents, as you will, in the analytics world. So we want to make machine learning a part of the analytics community, and we also want to link it to data governance.